Hi, I'm Cybergirl O, host of Real Biz in SL. We walked around the August Jackson Community Park to see what this communications company is up to in Second Life. You can see the entire tour by tuning into our show, Real Biz in SL, at slcn.tv. But until then, let's find out what August Jackson is really doing in Second Life with our 5 questions in 5 minutes. I've put their rep in the hot seat. Check it out. Okay, we are back in the Real Biz and SL studios. I am here with Eric Steidinger, the VP Executive Creative of August Jackson. We are talking now about the business side of things. So I'm going to ask you 5 questions in 5 minutes. Are you ready?
Yep.
Okay. He seems very nonchalant about this. Let's see what he has to say. Question number one. Investment. What kind of investment is your company making in Second Life?
Well, we're not going to go into the specific numbers of it. I'd say it's kind of a moderate and comfortable investment. We're stepping into it, as we go, creating what we need, and keeping an eye on it and seeing how it works and modulating it and letting it be an organic thing. So, I would say it's a significant investment, but. Don't want to go into the details of that.
Dodging that question. Everybody seems to be so good at that. Well, now I have to sit there and think,
sorry about that.
Can I get away with that? No, it's okay. I understand. I do get people occasionally to give me an actual dollar amount, and I always appreciate that, and I give them a free Real Biz and SL t-shirt for their efforts. So let's move on to question number two. ROI, what kind of return on your investment are you seeing so far?
Well, it's doing what it needs to do. When we reach out to clients and ask them, new clients that we've defined that we want to get in to see and demonstrate who we are and how we can be of value to them, when we present them with the idea of coming in and doing this presentation for them, the response has been very, very positive, and we've gotten in to see a lot of the people that we wanted to see. So I would say that's how we're measuring it, not against any specific numbers, against the specific investment. Is it working to do what we need it to do, and it is.
Well, I can see that because August Jackson is not building a build so that everyone can show up, so therefore you don't have those typical metrics. The fact that you're using your build as a demo of not just what Second Life can do, but a way to show what social media and community and all of those Web 2.0 things are, I think it makes sense that you have to go through a whole different metric system. So opening doors to new clients and new business is, I think, a good ROI.
That's what it's for.
Number three is measurement. What are the metrics you're using to evaluate your Second Life initiative?
The measurement really isn't an issue for us in the traditional way. It's not about how many people come through or how many people interact or how many people take something away from it. When we were doing the presentation, first, did we get in to see the people that we needed to see? And then, are they engaged in the presentation? Does this presentation get our clients to start talking about them and their needs? That's when a presentation is successful for us, when that allows us to start immediately responding with ideas to what they're trying to accomplish. And that demonstrates our ability to think. And for us, then if we walk out of that meeting having accomplished that and giving them an impression of who we are and how we think, then we would consider it a measured success.
But of course, there's got to be the money aspect, too. It's not just, are they thinking about these things, but are they doing business with you? Are they doing more business with you?
Yeah, but it's the presentation itself can only get you to the place where they're going to consider you for business. That itself won't drive the yes and no decision.
I think you've fallen asleep.
Do I fall asleep? Do I need to do something? Or hi,
just need to move on. I haven't bored you to tears. Because you have 5 questions in 5 minutes, not
half
that time.
I'm attentive now. There.
This leads into the number four anyway. My number four question is it worthwhile, bottom line, is it worth being in Second Life?
Absolutely. I don't think we could not be and be considered legitimate in our claims of of understanding how to use new media. We have to be out there working in it ourselves and using it for ourselves. Otherwise, we can't, you know, say to our clients we think it would be good for them. So it's a must-have, I think.
And then question number five is time. How much longer do you plan to spend in Second Life?
I think that, again, it comes down to what you have to do to be in the game. I will be in Second Life as long as Second Life is the place to be as it relates to virtual worlds, and as long as virtual worlds seem to have potent value for our clients. We need to be in there doing it for ourselves and then for our clients. So we'll be here as long as it's the best place to be in this realm of virtual worlds.
And right now, Second Life is the best place to be in terms of virtual worlds. I mean, that's my humble opinion.
Yeah, I believe so, too. I think it's got the broadest brand reach and understanding out there, and that has a lot to do with it. So,
excellent. Eric, it has been very interesting to see your company's take on Second Life. Thanks for giving us a tour, and residents can take lovely bike rides or walk through your park and even pick up some August Jackson t-shirts. Thanks very much. I appreciate it. It's been a little bit different, but different is good.
Thank you for your time.
This is Cyber Girl O for Real Biz in SL. We'll see you next time.